How's it going? How was the party? Okay. Well, the reason I'm calling is because I got a letter in the mail. And I decided to wait to open it until I could call you. Thank you. Pajama Bros! Dear Uncle. I think I like being pajama bros. What does that one say? We could, yeah, we could have fun bigger than we imagine. So keep up the good work. What? Yeah, I agree with that. We definitely could have a lot of fun, more than we can imagine. Thank you. I appreciate it. That's a very thoughtful thing of you to do. Pajama bros, pajama bros. Pajama Bros having some fun. So my goal is to make Pajama Kid a reality. Last night I went to my favorite fabric store, Affordable Textiles, where affordable is a relative term, straight to the jersey section. And now I'm gonna head to the thrift store. I'm gonna see if I can find some pajamas, because I've never made stuff for kids before, so maybe I can make a pattern out of it. Success. I acquired everything I need to get started. I've got my fabrics. And then I also got myself one of these long sleeve shirts, which I'm actually just going to copy verbatim. And then I got a pair of these, which are about the right size, but I think I'm going to taper in the legs because, well, ain't no superhero wearing such loose pants. So take these apart, make a pattern, and then get to work tomorrow morning. Voila, my many pattern pieces. And I'm gonna start off with the top. And now this is a really nice bamboo French terry, which, as you can see, has the look of regular jersey on the outside, but then on the inside has this soft texture on the inside. And for my sleeves, I was able to find this exact same fabric, but in a nice bright red. So I've doubled up my fabric here for two sleeves. And then for the leg, of interest is that this is actually a slightly different pattern where each leg is one whole piece, and then it just gets wrapped around like that, and then the two sides stitched together. And then this time I flipped the pattern the other way around because I need it to be mirrored for the other leg. You know? Turning to the collar and the cuffs. And now this is more of a spandexy elastic as opposed to a rib knit, but I think that'll work. And I'm gonna start right along the top, right by the shoulders. And then a quick top stitch along the shoulders as well. On with the sleeves. And then these sleeves are going to get a top stitching here too. Moving on to the collar here. Now just work my way around this collar. Make sure I give it all a good stretch so that it sits flat. A nice little zigzag stitch around this collar as well, just to hold everything in place. Starting to take shape, huh? Not bad. But I've got questions about this pajama kid. Sure, we've got a costume idea, we've got a name, but I need some meat on the bones of this character, like some of the quintessential superhero stuff. Now, luckily, Pajama Kid has already made a video about this for us, so why don't we start with strengths and weaknesses. And while he does that, and there's no reason I'm using this as an excuse, but we got to put the old badge on the front, and I haven't practiced this yet, so I need to do a few practice runs here. And then Pajama Kid, over to you, and then once we're good, I'll take over, all right? Wonderful.
That's my superhero there. He's very strong. Let's test his strength. I'll be punching the bear. And then let's see how strong he is. See? That's strong, man. He's so fast, he's faster than the Flash. With his super slippers. Let me see if I can get my slippers in there. And my weakness is coldness. Yeah, I'm kind of going crazy in my video right now.
All right, those are some solid thought through character points. I like those. I did come up with some solutions to the monogram, and the designer in me couldn't help but step in here and did a few iterations there. And I think what I'm gonna do is something like that. That's what I think I'm gonna do. Let's make the final version. So last week I bought this black jersey, and then I've got some of this interfacing, and then what this does is it just helps add some strength. From here, I just draw out my various shapes. Just curve around and curve again. Wunderbar, wunderbar. Right here, this thing is a little knife that just cuts the fabric as it goes through, so that way it has a nice clean edge when it sews right here. So what I can do is I just, this knob right here, I press it in, then I turn it, spin it around like that, and then it tucks away. And away we surge. Now the curve of this pea, this is the one that presented the most challenge to me earlier, so I think the trick here is just to go real slow. Tying these off, and so I just take the two sort of horizontal ones. Come, there we go. Just give both of those a nice tie. Center that, and then this is going to go underneath. A bit more work than I thought it was gonna be. Some stitches along the sides, and through the sleeves to close it up. It seems I forgot to put my little knifey thingy back, so I gotta do some manual trimming here. Fold a little more this way. Moving on to the wrists. Really give the elastic a stretch here. Alright, oh look at that. Nicely lined up too. And then finally, last step with this shirt is just hemming the bottom. And then just a single fold over, otherwise it gets too thick. And run this hem at the bottom. Look at that, the top is done. So we should check in with Pajama Kid again. Does he have a sidekick? Who's his nemesis?
My uncle, Cornelius Quiring. He also has a YouTube video, and he is my sidekick, Pajama Man. Has kind of the same powers as me. His powers are invisibility. And strong! And my brother's gonna be the bad guy. Because he is evil. Yeah, I'm evil. But I am the superhero. I'm gonna take him down. Wow. But sometimes I may fail. I want to tell my brother just to do it for fun.
Silly old uncle is your sidekick. Oh, jeez. You flatter too much, young man. Okay, moving on to the legs. So I'm going to run a seam up the inside of the leg. And I gotta connect them together. And so let me see here. That's the back. Okay, so we gotta connect the backs. And then give this the old surge too. Usually I do the crotch first and then the legs. Now it seems to be a switcheroo. My sister did send me the measurements, and so let me just check to see what the waistband was again. Plus, I'm making these slightly on the larger side, so that way, if they're a little bit too big, he can grow into them, and I'd rather it be too big than too small. All right, that will not be coming apart. Pin this elastic right up along the top of the waist and then evenly space it all out. So I'm stretching everything quite a bit so it levels out. Fold over once, fold over twice. Get this whole enchilada under here. It's gonna be thickest right here, but that's okay. Let me just get a little section. I gotta give this a nice tug so it's all straight. This stretchiness is presenting a real set of challenges for me here. All that's left is the elastic at the bottom of the pants. These stretchy fabrics are interesting to work with, that's for sure. All right, pants are done. The top finished earlier. So the base of Pajama Kid suit is ready. Next week, the real superhero stuff, the mask, the cape, the fun stuff. And so to close out, and not because we deserve it, but because we are ever so lucky, it seems that Pajama Kid even has a theme song. So over to you, Pajama Kid. Let's end it strong.
Pajama Kid, Pajama Kid, Pajama Kid. He's so, so strong. He's so, so fast. He's so, so smart. Can answer any test. He is so... Why is he so...